Everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm teacher Kathy, and I'm going to talk to you today about prices on my Outschool classes. I had someone say something to me a little while back, and I wanted to share it with you all. But before I do, don't forget to click that subscribe and the bell and the like button, because it really does help move me up in the YouTube channel world. All right, so I was in a networking meeting, and I had another teacher tell me that I'm not really pricing my classes to be marketing myself for what I'm worth. And I had a problem with this because I did some searching on Outschool as a parent, because I was at one point before I started teaching, and looking at classes that were similar to mine, similar topics, spelling, language arts, vocabulary, things like that. And they were all over the place, but majority of them were mid-range between 15 and let's say 25 at the most. 15 to 20, maybe 12 to 20, okay? I had some of my classes set at 10. I've had some set at 15 in the last couple of years. And I've recently just moved all my classes up that are group classes up to the recommended amount that Outschool now recommends as 18 is the bottom. They recommend 18 to 20. They used to recommend 15 to 18, I believe. But I didn't immediately go up when they changed that in the last 6 months or a year. I don't remember when it was. And I was blown away by the fact that some of the recommendations I've been given were charging, especially for one-on-one classes. I started charging 20 instead of the 15, and then a little bit less for group classes with multiple students. That one-on-one, the bare minimum they were saying was 30, but some were saying at least 50. Some teachers say $1 a minute, which I totally get. And most of my classes are 45 to 50 minutes. But my problem is that who can really afford that? And why do you want to limit yourself to just the students that can afford that? What about the ones that can afford that and need help, especially if you teach the core subjects like I do, like English, spelling, reading, writing, phonics? I mean, where are these kids supposed to get help after school? A lot of parents are using Outschool as like a tutoring service, is like extra help after school. And I'm sure a lot of you get students like that. I don't want to make it so those students can't afford it. And I'm not teaching to make a whole bunch of money. And yeah, having that extra money would be nice. I mean, who doesn't need more money? But I don't want to upset my other students. I don't want to upset students that I already have. I don't want to upset new incoming students and steer away the ones that really are struggling with their reading and need help. And I'm not saying that teachers that charge that much don't want to help them, but I can't bring myself to do it. But something I wanted to show you that I thought was interesting was, and so I'm going to turn on my screen share. I went into Outschool and I switched to my parent view and I went to find classes. So let's start with my spelling class, okay? So I just typed in spelling, all right? And I started looking. Okay, we got 10, we got 12, we got 9, we got 10, we got 12, 10, 11, 15, 14, 10, 9, 12, 10, 13, 10, 18, one-on-one, 10, 9, 10, 10, 12, 20, 10, okay, so it looks like I may be on the high end if I'm setting my classes at 18 for group spelling classes. So maybe I need to take mine down just a little bit, because right now I'm at the higher end of what is currently be listed on Outschool, and I'm probably not going to get as many bookings because parents are going to say they can't afford that. It's too much. I mean, the higher ones I'm seeing, 13, 15, so maybe I need to take it back down to 15 for my group classes, because I don't want to have parents look at this and say, well, this one's charging 18 and this one's charging 15. They're going to book the 15 over the 18. I mean, who wouldn't? I do that as a parent. I try to find the cheaper option. Why would I spend more money if I don't need to? Okay. So I know, and not every teacher is going to be a perfect fit, and not every teacher is going to fit. See, here's mine at 18. I'm one of the higher ones. I think I'm going to, after making this video, have to change that back down, because looking at this, most of the classes are set at anything 10 in between 10 and 15 is the average, not 20, not 25, not 30, not 40. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at the 101 because that was the big one that I was really being pushed to up my prices well above what I have it set at. So let's do 1-to-1. Okay, let's just type in 1-to-1 classes, see what comes up. Excuse me. So I've got 25, I've got 50, I've got 20, 35, 35, 2, 15, 23, 45, 40, 47. 28, 13, 25, 25, 30, 31, 32. Okay, so a lot of these, I'm seeing an average between 20 and 30. Okay? So they've kind of got a point there, but let's be a little more specific, not just 1-to-1. Let's be a little more specific and say 1-to-1 reading, because I have a bunch of reading classes that are really popular right now. Okay? And I've set them to be 1-to-1 instead of group classes because it works better with what I'm teaching. So we've got 20s, 8, 25, 25, 28, 30, 21, 8, 27, 30, 30, 14. Okay, so we're still up above 20. So I'm setting mine kind of lower. Mine are set at 20. Okay, so I can kind of see that I'm not completely within the market that's going right now. Let's change this a little bit because, see, I think the algorithm is a little bit different. 1-to-1 reading. Let's change it that way. Okay. 15, 55, 40, 40, 30, 28, 28, 28, 22, 25. So yeah, there you go. So it looks like the average right now, there's 18, there's 20, 25, 30, is I'm going to say between 20 and 30. So I'm right in that average, okay? So my point of making this video is I don't want others to feel intimidated by teachers telling them they're not charging enough or not what they're worth, because part of why I think a lot of teachers became teachers was to help students, was to be there for them, to help them learn. Because I know, for one, I get super excited when a student finally learns how to sit, read and say certain phonetic combinations, or finally learns how to spell certain word combinations that they're getting stuck on. And they accomplish that skill and they get much better, or writing out complete sentences. I mean, it's amazing and it's exciting, and you share their joy. And I don't want to take that away from any student. Now, my prices at 18 to 20 seem to be a fair price, and that's what works best for me in my situation. Now, I'm not saying those of you that need to make more money, if you want to do that and it's working for you, don't change it. But if what you're doing isn't working for you, consider lowering or hiring your prices accordingly to see if it works better. Because that's part of what I think the game is. But the average is not a dollar a minute for most people, okay? It's just not. All right, I hope that helps. And if I offended anyone, I apologize, but I just had to get it out there and kind of share what my opinion was and where I stood on it. Because my goal is to help students get better at their reading and writing and spelling skills, not to make a quick buck. I mean, I want to charge for what I'm doing and I want to get paid for it, but I also don't want to put it so high that the students that don't have a lot of money can't get help that they need. So, and right now, just an FYI, I'm a little over three quarters booked. I think I've only got three or four slots empty right now. So, obviously, I'm doing something right. All right. Have a good day. I hope you enjoyed it, and I look forward to seeing you in future videos. Bye-bye.